Back for the second half of our boys' opening match from the 2010 Hammer the Castle from Castle Lanes in Racine, Wisconsin. And Joey, David Schwartz got himself out to a nice lead early thanks to some early mistakes by Cody Holbeck, but no lead is safe in this match.
Well, yeah, and I'm sure David realized that. And he wants to just pile on some strikes early since he does have a good look and a great shot. Now there we see a tight line, no real curve to the ball, yet plenty of power when it gets there.
Absolutely. It's all about getting those bowling balls to store enough energy to get to the pocket. We've seen on the shows past with shorter patterns or players with a little less in the way of revolutions have a ball hook out, doesn't have anything left when it gets to the pocket. We've seen some five pins or four, five, sevens.
Right. And a bad release from that angle, he will leave a five pin or an 8-10, but again, off the hand clean, and there's a real good chance he's going to strike.
And a big break there, because that one he was not happy with, pulled up on it a little bit coming through the shot.
Yeah, I mean, and we never really look back at the good breaks. We always tend to remember the bad, but I mean, if that's the big four or big five, it's almost assured open, and here he can continue on with his clean game.
Yeah, filling frames. I mean, this is going to be one of those games grinded out, and if you can get 190 or 200, odds are you're probably going to win the game from your opponent. No, not. We usually start the kids off first term of the season with a little easier condition, but when we got to the TV show today, a little tougher than everybody expected at first, but the bowlers looked like they solved it during the practice session. Cody struggled a little bit in the first three frames, but he's thrown two good ones with a ball change, Joey.
Right. Now, when you say tougher, I mean, explain that to the viewers back home.
Well, it's just there's not as much oil in the middle of the lane to keep the ball from hooking to cross over or go through the nose if the bowler misses to the left of target. And to the right of target, or to the right side of the lane, the outsides of the lane, there's more oil than you'd see on a league pattern. So the ball doesn't have the recovery off the dry that a bowler would see if they were bowling during their normal
league. So, in other words, you have less targeting area to hit. You maybe have to be accurate to, say, a board or two at your target as opposed to three or four or five.
Plus speed as well, because, as obviously, hey, there's a great break for Cody. Interrupts us with a nice trip nine there.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, he's definitely thinking in this match. He's changed his angle. He's changed equipment on one lane. And that's what bowlers, good bowlers, should do. I mean, they won't blame the condition.
Yeah.
Just like a good golfer won't blame, oh, there's too many trees on the fairway, or the rough is too tall.
Yeah.
I mean, they simply observe and make their adjustments.
Absolutely. And that's one thing we've always seen at the Hammer U Challenge tournaments. The bowlers know these conditions are going to be tougher. Never hear people out of the bowlers or the parents saying, oh, the lanes were bad or stuff like that. They know when they make mistakes, and they admit it to themselves. It's making all these kids better bowlers right. When they in the high school programs and when they go to college.
And, you know, we find that in our sport league as well, Phil. I mean, the players, I mean, everyone struggles during the course of a season, but they won't say the lanes suck. They will say they suck.
Yeah.
You know, they will say the lanes were tougher this week, but that's an observation. But, I mean, the better the player, the less likelihood you're going to whine about it and grumble about it and rather than just make your adjustments.
Yeah, and as we were talking right before Cody tripped that nine earlier, a little bit extra speed there. David looked like he was on target with that shot, but if you get a little extra speed combined with oil, you get a little less friction, ball gets a little farther past the break point, and he's lucky to just leave that two-pin.
Right, and it should be a simple conversion.
Fairly straight at it. Covers it nicely.
A very contemporary but simple game, and it's really all you need in today's environment.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, he's going to be a junior this year at Racine Case. Same age as, you know, winner of this match is going to take on Ryan Zagar, another junior in high school this year. And you know, these kids are getting more and more talented, younger and younger in age. Cody's going to be a senior this year, I believe, at Burlington High School.
Well, that was left off his hand, and again, when you don't have that free swing to the right, the tendency is to sometimes pinch you, squeeze it a little, and you don't want to give up the pocket too much.
Exactly. But this should be a relatively simple spare for him. Move left, throw right. Don't overthrow it. That's where we've seen Cody get into trouble with spares in the past, and nice even tempo getting the line. He covers it up well. But he's running out of frames, Joey. Two frames to go and 32 pins in the hole.
Right, and it doesn't look as though David's going to give him too many openings because he's a good spare shooter as well. And you're right, at this point in the match, it's like being down six runs in a baseball game with an inning left.
Yeah. I want to thank our season-long sponsor this year, Action Heating and Cooling. They're going to be sponsoring some events at Motion Plus Lanes and also sponsoring during the Hammer U Challenge Series. I want to thank Joe Petkus and the rest of the staff down there. And Cody's just kind of struggling the last couple of shots.
I don't know. I think he's just lost focus and realizes the match is pretty much out of hand, and he's just trying to get off the lanes and let David shine a little bit here. I mean, he's had his moments, and it's good to have your opponent have their moments as well.
Absolutely, and I know Cody's looking forward to our next Hammer Youth Challenge tournament. It's the Chocolate City Challenge, and that's at Cody's home center out at Town and Country Lanes in Burlington. Marilyn and Teresa Draper out there hosting us, and they're going to have that all-star bowling tournament coming up around the corner again too, so scratch bowlers, watch for those entry forms in your mailboxes. Going to be the 19th year, I believe, for that telecast. So
and sounds about right. And free chocolate samples to everyone there. Just kidding.
And a great shot again by David. And if I'm Ryan Zagar sitting in the wings here, I'm going, I better really get my stuff together for this next match. Even though David's a good friend of mine, we see these kids bowling together in League of Castle Lanes. It's going to be a slugfest between the two.
You know, and I, as good as Ryan Zagar is, I might give the edge to David here since he's comfortable on the pair, and sometimes the less boards you cover on the tougher the pattern, the better chance you have to win.
Yeah, and I think more and more of these kids are learning that as we watch these tough patterns play out. And how about that? The Steve Grabowski makes an appearance first time
of
the season.
That's correct. And for those of you who can't remember what the Steve Grabowski is, it's when you get a wally shot like this and the five pin goes to the right as opposed to the left.
The left would be the Ted Grabowski. So the fine Grabowski bowling family in the greater Milwaukee area. Great supporters of the sport for years, and see what David can do. I thought maybe you'd do an area check, or
I just do that one pretty quick. I think I don't think it mattered too much to him, but a spare here, a fine 216 game,
and a clean game, which for as tough as this pattern is,
clean is worth its weight in gold on a USBC.
Exactly, covers it nicely, and if I'm Ryan Zagar, I'm gonna really make sure I watch where everybody. He was sitting down on the lanes before. Watching where both these guys are playing, and I'm sure when he comes back and takes his warm-ups before we come back for his match, he's probably going to be playing in the area more where David was than where Cody was.
Now, speaking of clean on this pattern, we'll give a little shout-out to Jeff Riggles of Madison. I believe he is the only bowler in the history of the tournament to go 90 clean.
He did that in, I believe, Huntsville, Alabama in 1997.
And Jeff is a great player. And I'll tell you, a lot of bowlers have had one or two opens in nine, which is still phenomenal.
Yep.
But Jeff to go 90 clean frames, that is unbelievable.
Yeah, and great. He's a great journalist, too. Really enjoy everything he does. And with that, Cody Holbeck's going to be back for the next tournament, I'm sure. Joey and I will be back for our semifinal game from the 2010 Hammer the Castle in just a couple of minutes.